I'm Gerardo Camilo, an associate professor of biology. The current project that is consuming the greatest amount of time in my lab is trying to understand how cities, especially so-called Rust Belt cities like St. Louis, Chicago, Detroit, have become refuge for native bees. I always say the worst place to learn science is in a classroom. You know, you learn science in a lab, you learn science in a field, you learn science by seeing and doing. So my expertise, when I take students out into the field, I'm taking them to the community gardens, I'm taking them to the urban farms, I'm taking them so they can see and understand, you know, what are the social, economic, and even ethnic dynamics of this food producing system, not just the bee part, but an entire history. This is tremendously important because most of all the fruits and vegetables and nuts that we consume are pollinated by bees. When we go to a restaurant, you want that tomato to be grown, you know, next door. That means growing it in the city. So every single bee that you observe here was collected within the city limits. And not only within city limits, they were collected within community gardens or urban farm or these tiny restoration sites inside the city. We have 111 species of bees that occur in these tiny community gardens. So there's something about growing food inside the city that allows bees to survive within the city much better.